So the next question is, the results given in the below table were obtained during kinetic studies of this reaction. So this is the reaction, 2A plus B gives C plus D. So we have done 5 experiments, concentration of A is given, B is given, and the initial rate is given. Okay. Then let's see what they are asking first. So what they are saying, that we have to find out X and Y. Okay. So we don't have to find out the order, we have to find out the concentration of X and Y. See, if I look at the first, if I compare the first and the second experiment, what I see, that the rate is becoming 4 times. The rate is becoming 4 times. So I can say from here that from experiment 1 and 2, the order of the reaction with respect to B, order with respect to B is 2, because we are doubling the concentration of B and the rate is becoming 4 times. Okay. Now let us look at the experiment number 1 and 3. So from experiment number 1 and 3, what do I get? I double the concentration of A and the rate is getting doubled. So which means that order with respect to A is 1. Okay, so order we have got. Now we have to find out the concentration of A and concentration of B. Now see, dear friends, here the things get slightly tricky, because there's something which we actually forget in such calculations. What is that? That is calculation of the rate constant. See, let me use the first experiment. From here I can say that R is equal to K, concentration of A raised to power 1, concentration of B raised to power 2. The value of R is 6 into 10 raised to power minus 3 is equal to K. What is the value of A? This is 0.1. What is the value of B? 0.1, but it is a square. So this will give you 0.001, that is 10 raised to power minus 3. Hence the value of K will come out to be 6. Okay. So the first thing that we had to do was calculate the order with respect to A and B. Second, we have to calculate the rate constant, and now we have to calculate the value of X and Y. Let us look at the experiment number 4. The rate is given to be 7.2 into 10 raised to power minus 2. Right? What is the value of K? K is 6. Then we have to put the concentration of A, that is X raised to power 1. Then the concentration of B, that is 0.2 raised to power 2. Okay, now we have to solve for X. So this is 7.2 into 10 raised to power minus 2. This is 6, X, and then 4 into 10 raised to power minus 2. Right, dear friends? So this 10 raised to power minus 2 gets cancelled out. So it is like 7.2 divided by 24, so the value will come out to be 0.3. So the value of X is 0.3. Okay, so there are two options, 2 and 4. We need to work out still more. So now why? We have to look at experiment number 5. So this will be, I'll solve it over here. The value of R is 2.88. into 10 raised to power minus 1, which is equal to 6 into 0.3 into y raised to power 2. Right? So now I have to solve for y, so which is equal to 2.88 divided by 6 into 3 square root, which is equal to 0.4. So dear friends, what is the value of X we are getting? 0.3. What is the value of Y you are getting? That is 0.4. So the correct answer is 2, right? Okay, numerical, bit lengthy, but 1 out of 25 can work, right? Considering this to be a above average question, let's go to the next question. The molecular geometry of SF6 is octahedral. What is the geometry of SF4, including the lone pair of electrons, if any? See, sulfur is having 6 electrons in the outermost shell, right? So let me make this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And it is bonded to 4 fluorine atoms. Right? So how many bond pairs you are seeing over here? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many lone pairs? 1. 4 bond pair, 1 lone pair. So total number of electron pairs is 5. According to VACPR, the hybridization should be sp3d, and in such a case the geometry would be trigonal bipyramidal. It will be trigonal bipyramidal. Now let us look at the next question. Amongst the following statement regarding absorption, those that are valid, so basically the statement which is true: delta H becomes less negative as adsorption proceeds. Yes, whether you are talking about the chemisorption, if you are talking about chemisorption, then the active sites are getting covered up. If you are talking about fissorption, the layers are being formed, so the attraction goes less. So the first statement is right, delta H becomes less negative as absorption proceeds. Okay. On a given adsorbent, ammonia is adsorbed more than nitrogen gas. Yes, because ammonia is polar in nature. Okay. A and B are correct. C, on adsorption, the residual force acting along the surface of the adsorbent increases. No, it will in fact decrease, because the adsorbate is, you know, coming and adsorbing on the surface of the adsorbent. So what is happening? The residual force is actually decreasing, not increasing, right? The residual force is decreased by this process of adsorption. With increase in temperature, the equilibrium concentration of adsorbate increases. No. Because the adsorption is a exothermic process. So in such case, the concentration of adsorbate will decrease with the increase in temperature, right? So only the option A and option B are correct. So the right answer should be choice number 2. So dear friend, this question actually is signifying that you have to go to the micro level in chapters like surface chemistry, wherein generally people, you know, they feel, oh, it's very easy, only you have to mug up the things. So it's more than mugging, you have to understand all this part, right? Let's go to the next question.